Hello there, this is Lynn Allen. Welcome to another AutoCAD tip courtesy of Cadalyst magazine. Thank you so much for joining me. Today we're going to talk about all things offset. And I know what you're thinking, really Lynn, because I know all there is to know about the offset command. Well, maybe you do, but maybe you don't. Let's take a look at some things that most people don't know about the offset command. We'll start off with the basics, of course. So I'm gonna be a good girl and I'm gonna grab the offset command from the ribbon, practice what I preach, right? And there, I'm sure you at least know there's two different basic methods of offsetting. You can give a specific offset distance, right? Or you can do a through option. Let's start off with through, which is the default. I'm gonna go ahead and grab this nice big green slot there. I get this great preview that was added into AutoCAD a few releases ago, like that. And then of course, wherever point you select, that is where the object is going to go through, right? Easy enough. Let's try it again. Let's set a specific distance this time. All right, and I'm gonna do a distance of 5. I'm gonna select the original object again, and you can see that I get a very nice visual as far as where it's gonna go. Easy peasy, piece of cake, right? Okay, let's undo those, put it back to the beginning. Now I'm gonna go back into the offset command, still continue to behave and grab it from the ribbon, and I'm gonna do a distance again. Now this time, I'm going to use the multiple option. This is great for those of you that need to do many, many offsets at one time and you're tired of going back and picking that original object again and again. You'll see that there is this great multiple option. So I'm gonna go ahead and select a place and another place and another place, and you just have a little offset party. I can even grab other objects if I need to along the way. Hit an enter to go to the next object, and I can continue offsetting that one as well. So that's when you want to do a whole bunch of offsets, same object over and over and over again. All right, let's get out of there. Let's undo that. And there is an undo inside of the offset command. That only undoes the last offset. I want them all back to the beginning. So I did a real life undo. All right, let's go back into the offset command again. Let's see what else is in there. What else is hiding in there? So I want you to notice that it has some settings across the top there. There's a setting for erase source. So the way we have it set up right now is it keeps the original object when it does the offset. But I could say E for erase and say, I want you to erase the source object when I'm done with it. Let's do through again. I'll go ahead and grab the slot, pick any place on the screen. Now you can see it kind of fades the original object. That's because it's gonna go away. Do it again over here with these holes. You'll see the original object is faded. That's because we told it to erase the source. All right, we'll undo that. And let's take a look again at all things offset. I typed it in, I cheated. Yeah, so we have erase source is still set to yes. How about layer? So as we do offsets in AutoCAD, by default, the offset lands on the same layer as the object that you selected. Well, what if I want the offset to go on the current layer? All right, let's try that. Let's go and select the L for layer. And this time, instead of source, we're gonna say C for current. We want it to go on the current layer. So you can see the current layer is layer 0, right? So let's go ahead and I'll give it a value. Go ahead and select the object. And you can see it's very clear it's going on a different layer this time. Come up here, it's not gonna go. It still says erase source is still set, so the original one goes away. But now when I do the offset, I'm doing it onto the current layer, whatever the current layer happens to be. All right, so let's go right back there one more time. We learned about erase, we learned about layer, offset gap type. I covered a few tips ago. You'll have to go back and look at that one if you're not familiar with that. And we also talked about the multiple option. So lots of different things you can do in the offset command. I hope you learned at least one trick. And now you are an offset wizard. Oh yeah. Thank you so much for joining me. I'll see you back here in 2 more weeks.